Welcome back to the Lightning Talks. Before lunchtime, before the break for the afternoon talks, we will have three more speakers. Apologies again for the 11:40 talk, which was cancelled because the speaker did not turn up. We now have Peter Tanik, which will talk about Babel Fish for DevOps. Enjoy the talk.
Hi, I'm Peter Tanik from Hungary. I'm community manager at Balbit, the upstream developer of Syslog.ng. Balbit is an IT security company, a mid-sized one, where still about two-thirds of employees can configure a Linux kernel, which I think it's quite an impressive number. First of all, a few words about logging. I experience most people outside of this room or outside of IT consider logging as cutting trees. But for us IT guys, logging is recording events on a computer. And here on screen, you can see a typical log message. It's an SSH login. Syslog.ng started over a decade ago as an enhanced log daemon with a much better configuration language and much more filtering possibilities. For this reason, it was often called the Swiss Army knife of logging. But over the years, many new features were gained. Support for the new syslog protocol, many different kind of parsers like JSON parser, message classification. One can normalize messages with syslog.ng and can forward messages for further processing to message queuing databases, both SQL and NoSQL databases. So a lot of things happened. So many of our users call syslog.ng now a babelfish for logging, even if I think we are not quite there yet, but on the way. We don't have too much time, here I would like to present four typical use cases for syslog.ng and how to achieve this. Along the way, I would like to present a few features of syslog.ng. Syslog.ng can present, it can receive and store many messages up to over half a million a second in some cases, but of course it's the goal is to be alert to know about the important messages. So there is a possibility to parse messages and receive an email about each root login. To achieve this, one needs an SMTP server and of course syslog.ng. How does it work? Syslog.ng can parse messages using PatternDB. I will talk about it in a few seconds later. It can filter on username root, and if there is a match, it can send off the result to an SMTP server. So let's talk about parsing and filtering. There are three parsers in syslog.ng. The first one was CSV parser, which can parse columnar data into fields. A typical example for this is Apache logs or similar logs. And then these fields can be used for many things, for filtering, for alerting, for just about anything. The next one is DB parser. which can parse information from unstructured log messages. Of course, to get it working, one needs an XML-based database which describes the log messages and the fields inside it. In SysLogNG's terminology, it's called PatternDB. And recently, a JSON parser was added to SysLogNG, so it can receive also JSON formatted messages and extract the fields from it. Sorry. As I mentioned, one of the original strengths of SysLogNG was filtering. It has it supports Boolean operations, many different kind of comparisons. It can also filter based on message content, and not only what was originally considered as a syslog message, but also on the macros and fields extracted by parsers. The next use case is getting more and more popular recently. It's logging anonymized JSON messages to MongoDB. To get this working, one needs JSON-based log messages, for example, as emitted by Node.js or other Java applications, of course, SysLogNG and a MongoDB server. SysLogNG can parse the JSON-based messages, extract the name value pairs. If there is a policy or compliance, because of compliance reasons, to anonymize part of the message, like a credit card number, IP address, or username, it can overwrite it with a simple string or with a hash of the original string, and then send off the name value pairs to MongoDB. SysLogNG can manipulate messages in many ways. One of the common reason for this that the application processing the log messages expects a specific form of messages. To achieve this, one can use templates and template functions in SysLogNG. You can see on the screen the default message template, but the possibilities are endless, especially as the results of message parsing, the newly created name value pairs can also add it to this mixture. And as I mentioned, SysLogNG can also modify log messages if necessary. For example, there are predefined functions to anonymize credit card numbers, which is part of the which is necessary for PCI DSS, for example. Also, recently, message queuing-based business logic is getting more and more popular, and SysLogNG can feed this with messages. Of course, for that you need SysLogNG and a supported messaging message queuing system. Right now, AMQP and STOMP destinations are supported, but coming soon is 0MQ. And as with the previous examples, SysLogNG receives the messages, it can parse and filter these messages and send off to message queuing system, which are important. The last example I would like to talk about is real-time statistics, as we are working on to support more of these systems. Right now, SysLogNG can support Redis and Riemann destinations for statistics and monitoring. And as previously mentioned, after filtering, parsing, filtering, messages can be sent off either the message or the name value pairs to the destinations. As I mentioned, people call us Babelfish, but of course there are quite some work needs to be done to be able to translate from all possible to all possible sources to all possible destinations. So, as far as I can see, there are quite a few students here in the room, and Google Summer of Code is coming again, and the SysLogNG project will participate this year again. So if you would like to join us and give this Babelfish another source or destination, then please visit us after the after my presentation. I will be here with my colleague after the presentation, and you can talk to us. If you have questions, oops.
Donations for new audios of the workout.
Right, okay, should be right now, sorry about that. Don't have a clue what was going on. Any questions? Anyone? No? Well, okay, I guess that's it then. Oh, okay, we have one. Fantastic.
Hi, is SysLogNG efficient enough to get a lot of logs from RabbitMQ bus, for example? Maybe, I don't know, 300, 400 servers emitting logs through RabbitMQ bus, MQP, and SysLogNG can get it?
Actually, I don't know. Actually, I don't know the numbers exactly, but here is one of my colleagues who did part of the development. So if you put hand on the microphone, he can answer the, this part of the question.
As far as I remember the numbers, we can reasonably process about 10,000 messages a second. Assuming you do expensive transformations on them. If you just best messages through, it's in the hundred thousands on normal hardware.
Right, any other questions? No? Okay, fantastic. Well, once again, thank you. Peter Czernik, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, so that's the talk. There will be another talk starting in 8 minutes.